free audio library.
Hi subscribers and viewers, welcome back to this channel. In this episode, I'm simply going to talk about Windows 11 operating system, the new Windows operating system from Microsoft. And it's actually an upgrade of Windows 10. They mostly have things in common, just that there is certain few changes that has been made to Windows 11 that makes it unique from Windows 10. Okay, so let's move on. Introducing Windows 11. So these are certain new things that has been introduced in Windows 11. Okay. A new Windows experience, bringing you closer to the people and things you love. So this is a short video describing how Windows 11 can be so helpful to us with its intuitive nature. You know, it's very nice. I like Windows 11. And it actually works almost similar to Android operating system because of how intuitive it is. So let's watch these short videos. Okay. I so like it so much. When you are using it on your computer, it's just like you are using your Android device. Okay. Eight widgets. So amazing. It's so amazing. It's so amazing, man. I like this device. Okay, so let's move on. Get a fresh perspective. Windows 11 provides a calm and creative space where you can pursue your passions through a fresh experience. From a rejuvenated stats menu to new ways to connect to your favorite people, news, games, and content, Windows 11 is the place to think, express and create in a natural way. So I think Windows 11 was created in a way that it is so intuitive, it makes you feel like a developer behind a computer. I think that's what Windows 11 was built for, and I like it that way. It helps you to bring out your realities, it helps you to bring out your creativity, and it's so nice. Maximize your productivity. As I said, exactly. Access all the apps you need and multitask with ease with tools like Snap Layouts, desktops, and a new, more intuitive redocking experience. Okay, so actually, Windows 11 gives you the option to work in between desktops. So you have one machine and you can actually switch in between desktops, and it's so amazing. So you can actually dedicate one desktop to maybe your Word and other Microsoft workouts. You can actually dedicate the next desktop to maybe your web browsing or your streaming and other stuff, and it's very good. It makes you more creative. New ways to connect instantly to the people you care about right from your desktop with Microsoft Teams, call or chat for free no matter what device they're on. So these are some of the inbuilt applications that comes with Windows 11. So this is why I said it works like Android, because most of these are Android devices, comes with inbuilt WhatsApp, Facebook and other applications. The same thing applies to Windows 11. It comes with inbuilt applications like Microsoft Teams, and you wouldn't have to actually download new one and install, and that makes it very intuitive and very good. It saves you bandwidth you will actually use to download most of these applications, and I think it's a plus for Microsoft. Your content created by you. Okay, so with Microsoft Edge, and mind you, Microsoft Edge is an inbuilt web browser that comes with Windows 11. With Microsoft Edge and a multitude of widgets you can choose from, you can quickly stay up to date with the news, information and entertainment that matters most to you. Easily find the apps you need and shows you love to watch in the new Microsoft Store. So, you know, the new Microsoft Store, the way it has been designed, comes, it's just like a widget, you know, where it comes up, it displays stuff for you, like things you can buy from the store, like news, like information and entertainment that matters most to you. Okay, with the gaming experiences, so Game Pass, Playtime, Anytime. Windows 11 takes gaming to a whole new level with graphic capabilities that rival reality. Discover your next favorite game with Xbox Game Pass, giving you access to over 100 high-quality games. Membership sold separately. Okay, so this is how good the graphics are in Windows 11 when you are playing games. And such games, you can get them from Xbox Game. Okay, you can choose to buy if you are so interested in a particular game. But this is how, or these are how you can actually have a good graphics on Windows 11, and it's very intuitive and very nice. You know, a PC for each of us. The new Windows is available on the widest array of devices, from our partners who are bringing you the latest innovations in touch, pen and voice, making it easy to find the best, most affordable device for you. So basically, this Windows 11, it has compatibility issues. You can't install Windows 11 on any other computer that is not compatible with it. It needs to be compatible, else it will not be successful. So in a short while, we'll go into its compatibility, its requirements, before it can work effectively. So when we move on, okay, it says find the right PC for you. Need a new PC now? There are some Windows 10 computers that can upgrade for free when Windows 11 rolls out, and it's so much easier to transfer to a new computer when you back up your files and photos from your old PC to OneDrive. So OneDrive is a cloud storage, just like Google Cloud, yeah, or you know, Apple Cloud, all those cloud storage, you know, technologies. You can actually do this. You can actually back up your files and photos from your old PC and actually save it on your OneDrive. Okay, so these are, oh, Charlie, something. So we have some minimum system requirements here. These are the things you need before you can actually install Windows 11. So with the processor, we have about 1 gigahertz or faster with 2 or more cores on a compatible 64-bit processor or system on a chip. With the memory, you need 4 gig RAM or above. With the storage, you need 64 gig or larger storage device. These are the key things you need. The storage and other stuff are secondary issues where you can add them up. You can actually buy them in shops and add them up. But this particular thing, that's the system firmware. If you don't have these two features under the system framework, that's UEFI and Secure Boot Capable, there's no way you'll be able to install Windows 11 on your device. If this system firmwares are not found in your computer, there is no way Windows 11 will be able to boot. So take that in note. You need these two things. Unless there are updates that will exclude this particular demand. You need a trusted platform module, version 2.0. You need graphics card, that's DirectX 12 compatible graphics for your gaming and your good HD displays. With the display, you need 9 inch with HD resolution of 720 pixels or above. With the internet connection, you need Microsoft account and internet connectivity required for setup for Windows 11 Home. So, unlike Windows 10, where you can bypass your Microsoft account and then proceed and then create your Windows 10 operating system. With Windows 11, you actually need a Microsoft account to proceed from there to the main desktop. Else, I'm afraid it wouldn't proceed from there. And so they've provided us with a number of shops you can actually buy Windows 11 compatible computers, and these are retailers. You can get them from Best Buy, Walmart, Amazon, Micro Center, and Microsoft Store. So these are certain retail shops you can buy Windows 11 compatible PCs. Else, if you have your computer which has these two important things in the system firmware, then you are good to go. You can actually install your Windows 11. But if you don't have this in your computer, but you have all these other requirements, it will still not work until you have UEFI and Secure Boot Capable. Okay, so this is it about Windows 11 and the things you find in them and its requirements. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. Please subscribe, like, and share my videos. I'll be coming up with the next video, which is what it means to have Windows 11 as a developer. Okay. Thank you for watching this video once more. Free audio.